For me as a scientist, it's something I'd always wanted to be. And this has been my driving motivation every day when I come to work. Currently, my research group and I are investigating the use of ultrasound as an alternative activation technology to perform chemistry. What we are doing is that we investigate how cavitation bubbles can be used as microreactors. And then in so doing, we probe into the activation of these molecules either inside the cavity of the bubbles to cleave or paralyze them or at the bubble-liquid interface. We are also performing high-throughput experimental investigations to be able to assess how cavitation bubbles are formed, where they are formed, and this will allow us to control the behavior or the dynamics of cavitation bubbles to be able to perform chemistry. So what we are doing is that when we prepare our catalytic cavitation agent, we use ultra rapid high-speed camera to visualize the formation, the growth, and the collapse of cavitation bubbles in situ. In this way, we can have an idea on where the cavitation bubbles form on the surface of the catalytic materials. And this can now allow us to control the bubbles and also finally control the kind of reactions that we perform with this technology. Cavitation bubbles formation and collapse is very random. And it's very difficult to visualize these cavitation bubbles, especially for anyone working on sonochemistry. So currently, what we are doing is to couple ultra high speed camera visualization with our sonochemistry. And this allows us to be able to in situ visualize where the cavitation bubbles are formed, how they grow, and how they collapse. And this allows us to control these dynamics on the surface of catalytic materials. And in so doing, we'll be able to control catalytic reactions to improve the efficiency of our chemistry. We are also working in collaboration with Ghana, a world-leading producer of cacao. Usually, when the cacao beans are extracted and exported abroad for the manufacturing of chocolates, the waste cocoa pod husks are left on the farm to rot. And this causes a lot of problems to the yield of cocoa pod husk. So what we are doing in our research group with our technology and in collaboration with a startup company in IC2MP, we transform these waste materials into water-soluble sugars. And these sugars are sent back to the chocolate manufacturing companies to prepare or produce your chocolate that you eat. My research group and I working in collaboration with researchers from Singapore, Oxford, and Australia have been able to redesign catalytic materials to function as catalytic cavitation agents. Here, we specifically engineered cavities on catalytic materials, and this material was able to reduce the global energy needed to nucleate cavitation bubbles. And this was also used in performing chemistry to achieve good selectivity with good productivity. Being a scientist afforded me the opportunity to pursue really ambitious scientific projects that are the forefront of science and pushing the barriers or the frontiers of science. And I love being a researcher or a scientist because it affords me the opportunity to contribute to solving the global of environmental problems and challenges that faces us as humankind. For me, being at the CNRS is both a privilege and an honor. A privilege because CNRS is a prestigious research institution and widely recognized. And an honor because at the CNRS, you are surrounded by pioneers in many fields. And this allows young researchers to grow as scientists. And also in the field of research, CNRS provides a platform to be able to pursue ambitious research with cutting-edge technologies. And this medal, it's really an honor to me and my research group because it recognizes the hard work that we are doing on sonocatalysis and also recognizes that sonocatalysis can be a cutting-edge technology for the advancement of sustainable chemistry. For me as a researcher, every day presents new challenges. So every day in the morning when you wake up and go to the lab, you are full of excitement to see results from previous works that work that would be a wow experiment or results that will give you a new idea to pursue other ambitious projects. And for me, this is one aspect of my work that I love the most.